Welcome to the Dyer County Fair.
We have a good thing growing at the 2015 Dyer County Fair. We'd like to welcome you to the 68th annual Dyer County Fair and our broadcasts of the sights and sounds of the 2015 Dyer County Fair with your hosts, Debbie Bradshaw Hart and Eric Maupin. Make plans to attend every night of the fair, including the crowning of the 2015 Miss Dyer County Fair. Don't miss any of the pageants, and also the King of Kings go-kart racing. A truck and tractor pull, livestock shows, fun for the kids, youth exhibits, the 4-H barnyard, commercial exhibits, Sorghum Valley, and this year's Midway features Dixieland Carnival Company. And don't forget, every night, we give away $1,000 from the First Citizens Amphitheater at 10:30. But remember, you must be present to win. Enjoy rides, games, pageants, exhibits, live Christian music, and with your admission on Saturday night, you get one of country music's premier artists, John Anderson, at the First Citizens Amphitheater, and so much more at this year's fair. Now to bring you up to date with what's going on, here's Debbie Bradshaw Hart and Eric Maupin.
Good evening and welcome to the final edition of the 2015 Dyer County Fair. Can you believe it's Friday night already?
I cannot believe it. Friday night. We have had an absolutely wonderful week though, haven't we?
We have had a wonderful week.
And I'm sorry that I look like this. Absolutely. I did not get a chance to go home all day. I thought I would get
What were you going to wear for the final night?
Oh, it was going to be beautiful.
Yes,
it was going to be beautiful. Had a sequence dress.
Oh.
I was going to have my hair all curled with a mullet.
And a crown?
And a crown.
I thought maybe you were going to bring out the tux and all that nice
well,
stuff.
Well, I can next year.
Next year, that's the way we can open the show.
That's right.
I'll be wearing a tux. King Eric
and Queen Debbie.
There you go. King and Queen of the Dyer County Fair.
You know, Queen Debbie, it just kind of rolls off the tongue, doesn't it?
Yeah, that's what Paul says. He says, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you were doing the auctioneering a while ago. I said, yeah, Paul says I sound like that sometimes.
My wife does too.
Exactly. Anyway, tonight is Friday here at the Dyer County Fair. We've had Kids Day today, and the USA Pullers Truck and Tractor Pull is tonight, along with the $1,000 giveaway and a new car at 10:30.
New car, 10:30. I can't wait. Somebody's driving off of the fairgrounds in a brand new Versa.
2015 Nissan Versa. What color is it?
It's like a maroon. Yeah, red.
Maroon?
It's beautiful. Burgundy.
Burgundy.
There we go. Burgundy color.
Burgundy. That's the correct color. All right. Yes, we have kind of been without a little air earlier, and Lord knows it's a little hot, but it's getting better. It's getting better already because these lights make it worse.
That's right.
Okay. I think that we have a little bit of footage here from last night when Chuck Asa interviewed Highway 22.
Highway 22 is a new trio that opened up for the Karen Peck and New River concert, and I'm going to tell you, they were fantastic. That girl has some lungs on her, and then Karen Peck and New River put on a concert out of this world.
I was very impressed with them. I really was. Yeah, well, let's go to Chuck and look at the footage that he shot last night.
We have a special guest with us here tonight, and an opening act that will be coming up before Karen Peck, but this is an act that you are going to want to see. We have with us right now the three members of Highway 22, and let's first of all find out who they are. What's your name?
I'm Bethany Ellis.
All right. You must sing.
Maybe. Sometimes.
Okay. And you are?
I'm Blake Stanfield.
Nice to see you, Blake. And you?
And I'm Jeremy Smith.
All right, Jeremy. What do you guys do singing?
Well, we do a lot of Southern gospel. We do some contemporary praise and worship and stuff like that. We're based off of Highway 22. That's kind of how we got our name. And we do a lot of churches, you know, special events such as this one and things like that. And we just go and worship the Lord and praise the Lord and how He has us to do it.
All right. We're going to get an opportunity. This will be my first time of hearing you guys sing. How many shows do you do a year?
It just depends. Here lately, we've been doing two shows every weekend. So, you know, it just depends on how much you go every year. And around Christmas, it slows down. So,
how about mostly in churches, or do you do a lot of venues like this?
Mostly churches. I think this is the first fair that we've done. We've done Relay for Life in the past, but I think this is the first fair.
Okay, so this is the perfect one because this is the biggest one.
Yay, that's good. I like it.
And we got lots of fair food, too, so you guys eat up, okay? Woo. It's all right. Now, we're going to listen to them tonight, and we'll, of course, be closing our show with some of their music, so stay tuned for that.
Welcome back to the 2015 Dyer County Fair. This is our final night of the show. Eric, let's talk about some of the sponsors we've had this week. Let's start with Monday. We had
Hometown Urgent Care, Tracy Woodward.
She did a great interview.
She really did.
And nice
she
girl.
She is a wonderful nurse practitioner. So if you don't have a practitioner of your family, for your family, go see Hometown Urgent Care. She does a wonderful job.
Yes, she does. And she's building a new facility out here by Rick Hill Nissan that's on, what is that highway out here now? That's
Millsfield Highway.
Millsfield Highway. That's exactly what it is. That's how everybody knows what the name of the street is. Okay, on Tuesday, of course, it's the Dyer County Chamber of Commerce. And on Wednesday, Security Bank, who hosted our Special Needs Kids Day, and also the Century Farms Dinner that we had honoring the 100-year farms here in Dyer County.
Yes, the Roses, Bill and
Martha
Rose, were new inductees into the Century Farm this year.
And how many are there? How many?
You know, I really don't know. It's more than you would think, actually,
really?
In Dyer County. That and it was interesting. I have to tell this real quick. There was one year that the farm was in Dyer County when it was purchased, but now it's in another county.
Really?
Yes. Over the years, it's been here so long and in that same family for so long that the original deed was in a different county, but we inducted them here because when they purchased it, it was in Dyer County. The county became smaller as other counties came about.
That's pretty neat.
So we're going back to the settling of Tennessee, really.
Wow, that's pretty interesting. On Thursday, of course, we have Senior Citizens Day, very fitting, and First Citizens does such a great job with them. They serve hamburgers about 11 o'clock, and they play bingo, and you do not mess with them when they play bingo.
Oh, there is so many things, and the senior citizens absolutely love it. And we carry them, they'll have wagons to carry them up the hill and
they
down
do.
The hill and kind of open up the fair for the seniors of this area. And we absolutely love it when they come out because they tell us all sorts of things that happened way back when that maybe we had forgotten.
That's right. And then we have Sargum Valley, and we've had entertainment there every afternoon starting about 4 o'clock. Of course, that's about to wind down now because it's about time to tear down the fairgrounds again.
I know.
I know. It's hard
so
to believe. It is, but it's a lot of jam-packed things into one week. On Friday, we have Kids Day hosted by Burke's Beverage of Dyersburg. And then we have the USA Pullers, Truck and Tractor Pull.
On Friday night, I can't wait. I can't wait. It's tonight.
It is tonight.
Tonight.
That's what I was going to say. Can't wait.
Well, I know.
What day do you think it is,
Eric? As soon as we get through here, I'm going to the Truck and Tractor Pull, folks.
That's
Y'all
right.
can forget it. And then tomorrow night at 8 o'clock, don't miss it, John Anderson live in concert. All you have to do is pay to get into the fairgrounds, and it's
$5.
Free. $5 gate, and
that's, right.
that's all you need.
Another thing we need to mention, too, is the Mud Bog.
Yes.
That's on Saturday night, and there's a $15 entry fee. I think you have to be 18 in order to participate in the Mud Bog, but that's across the street at the Riding Arena, and if you're an ATV person, ATV, UTV, I think it's both.
That's right, mud's flying,
then
swinging
that's
up in
right.
the air. Those guys, when they come out of that pit, they are solid mud.
I know.
Absolutely solid mud. I don't even know how they see. Of course, they have helmets on, but it's absolutely amazing to watch them over there at the Mud Bog. So if you haven't gone to one of those before, you need to.
Yeah, it'll be a lot of fun. And I think at the end, you get to all the spectators, whoever wants to run through the arena over there with all the mud can. I think they let the little kids run and all that stuff. Oh, we have some little kids over here. They're so fun. That's what this is all about.
It is. All
it's
about the kids.
All the kids and all the older kids that just can't get enough.
I was going to say, we keep saying kids, but when we say kids, it's a heart matter. It's not an age matter.
Kids at heart.
I see people like me and you. We get out on that midway. It's all a heart matter. I turn into a
it
kid
is a
again.
Heart matter because I almost have a heart attack.
That's right. That's right. I love it. So Saturday night, John Anderson, don't miss that. You've still got time to come and enjoy the fair. 8 o'clock, John Anderson, and the Mud Bog's going on about the same time. It'll be going on probably till
around
10
8, yeah.
O'clock. I think it starts at 8, is that right?
It does.
8
it
o'clock, the Mud Bog. 8 o'clock, John Anderson. Both of them, you can go back and forth once you pay to get in both places. So don't miss it Saturday night. Right now, I think we've got some footage. Speaking earlier of Sargum Valley,
yes,
Chuck was down at Sargum Valley. We've got a new addition. We have a milk parlor, and he was actually interviewing the lady whose family helped put that in and install it in Sargum Valley. If you haven't seen that, you need to go see it. Let's go right now to Chuck.
Sounds good.
Well, Debbie and Eric, we have dedicated a lot of this show today to Sargum Valley, and one of the things that is new this year is a milking parlor. And for those of us who are raised on a dairy farm, milking happens every morning and every night, Christmas Day, Thanksgiving Day, Sunday, doesn't matter. There are no rests for that. But this is donated. The Baker family has come together, Sandy, Brad, and Todd, to dedicate this to your mom and dad who were dairy farmers for a long time. Sandy, I know this is tough talking about your mom and dad,
good.
but bring us up to date. How did you come about doing this for Sargum Valley?
Okay. Chuck, I was raised showing cows, as you said, and I was also raised at the Dyer County Fair.
Good deal.
Okay. This was our way to bring those two things together.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We on a dairy farm, as you say, you don't go on vacation very often. It has to be what happens between 12 hours. So you go on vacation. 12 hours later, you're back.
Mm-hmm.
So the Dyer County Fair was kind of what fit in our vacation time when we were raising cows.
Wow. So, and then you all decided to build this. How long did it take you to do this?
We started... It had kind of been an idea of mine for a few years. I went to the executive board at the end of the fair last year,
mm-hmm.
and we, my daughter and son-in-law, who are not here, and their granddaughter, we kind of threw the idea out to the executive board, and they were good with it. And so we started about 3 weeks after the fair last year, and we were good to go when Sargum Valley opened for Christmas.
Well, that's wonderful. Now, in here, we have a Holstein cow. Explain a little more about what's in here so people will come and see it.
Okay. We want people to come enjoy this. In Dyer County, several years ago, there were lots of dairies, and they're not here anymore. And this was our way to pay tribute back to those dairymen who spent lots of time and came to show off their prize cows at the Dyer County Fair. So this was like the big event where they all got together and have fun and show their cows. And this was our way to give back to them.
That's excellent. I notice you've got some pictures in there. What are those?
Well, we have a picture right here. We have our model cow in here and the one-legged milking stool and a rocker that belonged to my father's great uncle.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of tied together with baling wire, but it's still a good rocker. And we've got a picture of my father, Tom Bell, showing Skylark.
Mm-hmm.
Skylark was one of our favorite cows. And in the 70s,
mm-hmm.
she won the state fair 10 times in a row.
Wow.
So she was our claim to fame. We all really liked Skylark. There's one picture of Daddy showing her. There is also one picture in the back where it was in about 1965 at the old Dyer County Fairgrounds.
Mm-hmm.
And my grandparents had all of their grandchildren there. And we lined up Skylark.
Uh-huh.
And so we have the picture of Skylark with my granddaddy, my grandmother, and about seven of us grandchildren. So
yeah.
We filled her up that time. When my parents chose to get out of the dairy business in 93, they came, and the last year that we showed here, they had their picture made with my children.
Wow.
At the Dyer County Fair.
So it all happens right here at the Dyer County Fair, and it's been a part of our lives for, well, 68 years anyway.
I'm only 55.
It's 68. This is the 68th annual.
Okay. I thought you were trying to get me there.
No.
I'll hold true for 55. Yes, it is the 68th year, and we love the Dyer County Fair.
And that's why you need to come out here. And we're going to turn it back to Eric and Debbie and see what else is going on. Thanks, guys.
One of the things we need to do tonight is be sure and thank some of our people who have helped so much this week, especially with our set. Mike Pennington at Pennington Seed and Supply has helped us out this week with our furniture here that we like so much.
It looks so great.
And it's really so does. Comfortable.
It is.
Yes, it is. It's very comfortable.
And you can have it. Go buy something else at Pennington Seed and Supply.
They have so many things down there.
This.
I wish that they could pan around because we have some glass sunflower-like flowers over here in the hay bales. And they look so cute. And we had Joe Jennings. Joe was in here working on some of the booths here in the commercial building. And he helped us kind of do the set. We were just kind of setting mums up here in pumpkins. And he said, oh, no, we can't do that.
That's right.
So Joe's done a great job helping us out, too. And we also want to give a big shout out to James Roy Pope.
Pope's concession stand is they're a staple here at the Dyer County Fair. They've been here forever, it seems like. But we're, you know, you think about concession stands at a fair, and you don't realize that Pope's concession stand has been in the family for generations.
They have.
His mother works the cotton candy booth.
That's right.
I remember when his dad was out here every year.
His wife, Petrina.
His wife, Petrina. His son is out here. His sister used to be out here.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we're talking about truly a family fair. And
that's
believe
right.
it or not, they take a lot of pride in what they do.
Yes, they do. They're very serious about it.
They're serious about
their food.
This
is their livelihood. This is what they do. They start in fairs. What do you think? Probably May in festivals. They start in May
April.
And probably April.
Yeah.
And they go nonstop until about the end of September, the 1st of October. And then can you imagine how they're totally exhausted?
Oh, yes.
I can't imagine with all the heat and traveling because they start north of Dyersburg usually and they work their way down south.
All the way down to Florida.
Yeah.
So they go a long way. We also want to thank Dixieland Carnivals. They're a new carnival coming up. You know, Myers that we had for so many years decided to retire, another family business. But Billy Tucker and his lovely wife have stepped up and they have a wonderful carnival. And it's continuing to get better each and every year.
It is. I've heard lots of compliments from people about the workers they have and how good they are to the kids and all. And that's what we want to hear because we want to have a first-class act here at the Dyer County Fair.
They do. And I just want to say this about the Tuckers. Not a lot of people know this, but every night he and his wife have a staff meeting before the carnival opens. You'll never see this because it's early in the day. They have a staff meeting. They talk about what they want to accomplish. They talk about any problems that they had the night before.
Cool.
And so that's something they do, and it works really well. The people running the rides can tell them, hey, this is what happened last night. I liked it. I didn't like it. Whatever. And so very, very, very professional.
That's great. That's great. I mean, that's why you're supposed to run a business.
That's exactly right.
You know, work with your employees and everybody kind of talk about it and everything seems to work. That's what we do with all the fair directors. We all, if something doesn't work, we say, okay, well, if it doesn't work, we'll fix it. We'll move on and do something else.
Yeah. Top-notch folks.
Yes, absolutely. We have some more footage that Chuck's been around the fairgrounds this week. And I think, matter of fact, I think he had somebody help him. But before I move on to that, though, I want to say thank you to Paul Stringham, who has been our cameraman all week long, and to Chuck Asa, who is our new producer, who we love dearly, and he's helped us so much, and also to Tim Gamble and his wife, Felicia. And that's the reason I backed up is because Felicia was running the camera for us to do some footage, and when she introduces herself, we want you to know who she is.
We have a wonderful staff, all of those guys, so if you see them out somewhere, give them a great big hug and say thank you. You put on a good show.
Absolutely.
Each year here at the Dyer County Fair, we dedicate special days for special people. Every year, we have Special Needs Day, sponsored by Security Bank, where we bring a bunch of lovely children into the Dyer County Fair, and we let them ride rides, we let them enjoy the games and all of the fun stuff that happen with the fair. And not only can they ride the rides, but they can enjoy the things we only get to do once a year, like the fair food and gathering together with people we haven't seen since the last fair. They so much enjoy themselves, and you can tell by the smiles on their faces every time that they come to the Dyer County Fair. They not only enjoy the food we give them, but they enjoy the fun and fellowship with each other.
And Special Needs Day is not the only thing we do. We have the Senior Citizens Day as well, sponsored by First Citizens National Bank. One of the most important things they say we do is bingo, and everybody enjoys it. There's all kinds of fun here.
Hi, what is your name?
My name is Crystal Centel. I work for First Citizens National Bank.
Okay, and what do you do there?
I do public relations, so.
Oh, awesome, awesome. Now, what is First Citizens doing today?
First Citizens is, once again, happy to be out here for the Senior Citizens Day. This is, I think, our 22nd year to be out here and serving the senior citizens of our community. We at the bank, we are all about community and service and making everyone just feel welcomed. And we are happy to be here and to serve lunch. And you can hear in the background we're playing bingo, and we have lots of bingo prizes. And we know that many of these citizens look forward to this day throughout the whole year. And so we are here to completely serve them.
That's great, Crystal. Thank you. I'm sure that they are enjoying themselves. There seem to be.
We hope so. And we're having a great time as well.
Well, thank you for being part of the Dyer County Fair.
Of course. Happy to be here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, how are y'all today?
Doing, man?
Hey, what is your name?
My name's Sterling, man.
Good. It's nice to meet you, Sterling. So what do you like about the fair?
Everything.
Everything? Well, yes, good. Good. Are you enjoying your day today?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Awesome. Well, I hope you do, too. Good luck to you.
Yes, ma'am.
How are y'all today?
We're good. How about
you? Good. I'm doing fine. And what is your name?
Patricia Thompson.
Oh, hi, Patricia. And your name?
Judy Strayhorn.
What do you ladies like about the fair this year?
Well, I just got here, so I really don't know yet.
Oh, you hadn't had a chance to go around and look.
No.
Oh, well, there's a lot of good things going on. I hear they're making sorghum today, too, so
well,
have to be sure and get some of that.
Yeah,
so.
Sounds good.
Well, good. Well, y'all enjoy your day today. It's good to have you here at the Dyer County Fair.
Thank
you. Good, good. Let's turn around and wave at the camera for me today. Now, what is your name?
Hey, Ruth Whitson.
Oh, and what is your name, ma'am?
Annabelle Jones.
Oh, so what do you guys like about the fair today?
It's nice. We just got here, but it's real nice.
Now, where are you from?
Tiptonville.
Tiptonville. You guys traveled a little bit of a ways this morning to get here. Well, awesome. Well, I hope you enjoy your fair today, and we're glad to have you out here with us.
Where's Jeff Box at? Have you seen him?
No, ma'am, I haven't, but I'm sure he's wandering around here somewhere.
Well, tell him hi. I'm his aunt.
Okay, I'll do that.
Besides bingo, the next huge thing on Senior Citizens Day is the sorghum making. That began about a week ago when we go on the farm of Johnny Dodson and we harvest the pure cane sugar. That comes in and it takes them about an afternoon to make what is called good old-fashioned sorghum molasses. It's made right here in Sorghum Valley. And finally, Kids Day is another example of how much we enjoy having the kids out at the fair. They come in on Friday and have an entire day to themselves to ride rides, to play games, and to enjoy wonderful food and festivities at the Dyer County Fair.
Welcome back. It's the last of
And what did I just say about Chuck Ethan? I was talking about what a great guy he is
and then he
what a good producer. And he makes you cry?
Yeah,
what
he
is
makes
that?
You cry. Well, it's the last show.
I know. You think the people at home are glad? They're like, really? Do we have to watch this one more time?
Yeah. It's kind of like the guy, I asked him if he had seen President Obama's last, or heard President Obama's last speech, and he said, I hope so. Anyway,
you are full of jokes. I have to say, you've got
this is the last night of the show, and I'm going to tell you, I see Debbie from time to time. We see each other at Kroger. We live in the same city, but you know, we spend so much time together at the fair. Actually, this week I have spent more time with Debbie than I have my own wife,
and I'm sure
you can say that about Paul.
Exactly.
But I miss it. I really do.
I know. We have a good time. We enjoy this.
We have a great time. The fair is a wonderful, wonderful place to be. That's the way we want it to be. It is a community effort. It's the biggest event in our county, and we want you to enjoy it. If you're watching and you're from Shelby County, Hardin County, McNairy County, regardless of where you are, if you get an opportunity, come to the Dyer County Fair. We still have one night left. I know you'll enjoy it. It's not just a county fair. It is a county event.
It is a
West Tennessee
event.
We love it, we have a good time, and we want you to share it with us.
And it starts on Labor Day every year. So it's easy to keep up with because it's right. always on Labor Day.
And tomorrow night would be a good night to come. Tomorrow night, John Anderson live in concert. We can't say that too much.
No. Nope.
8 o'clock, just a swinging. And if you want to see us, we'll be out there swinging.
That's
somewhere.
Right. We will be, or at the Mud Bog.
That's right.
Might be over there. You never can tell.
We'll probably go to both places.
I wouldn't doubt it. I would not doubt it a bit. We do have a really good time doing the show, as I'm sure y'all can all tell. And we always hate when it's over with. We are excited when it starts, and then it just kind of, you know, mushrooms for the week. So we really do enjoy it. Eric, I enjoy doing the show with you. It's lots of fun.
Too, yes.
Yeah, it's lots of fun. And like we said to the camera guys and to Chuck, thank y'all again. We love y'all. Thank you so much. Same time next year. Just hope and pray that we're all here.
That's right. And if there are things you like about the show, get on our website and give us a little note and tell us what you do like. If there's something you don't like about the show, keep that to yourself if you don't mind. No kidding.
Be kind to others.
We want to get better. So send us a note. Let us know things you would like to see on our show or on our program.
Sure.
If you would like to see more kids, for example, then just give us a little note and we will take it as friendly
That's
criticism.
Right. Exactly. Yes, we will.
Tonight, we're going to end our show. Thank you for tuning in. Hopefully, this isn't the first time. Hopefully, you've tuned in all week. But we're going to end the show with a three-time Grammy-nominated artist that was here on Thursday night, Karen Peck and New River, and one of her staple songs in Southern gospel music, 4 Days Late. I hope you enjoy.
Really. God bless you. We'll see you next year.
You talk about a treat tonight. We have something, and there's a rumor circulating. I need to find out if this is true, that you guys have been here before many, many years ago. Is that true?
You know what? We were wondering if we had been here several years ago, but if we have, it's been a few years.
Well, here's the thing. Here's the thing. We are so glad to have you here tonight. I'm with Karen Peck, and New River is here. She's going to be performing tonight. And one of the things that I want to ask you about before we get deep into this thing is you did a song that is a staple in music. It is 4 Days Late. I want you to tell me just a little bit about, I'm getting goose pimples now. Sorry about that. About the background on that song.
Well, actually, we heard this song, I would say 15 years ago, mm-hmm. and going on 16. Mm-hmm. And we had Aaron Wilburn was sitting in Meridian, Mississippi, on mm-hmm. the stage, and he said, "I have written a song, and I wrote it several years ago, but I just want to sing you this. This is one of my favorite songs that I've written." Mm-hmm. And he sang 4 Days Late, and I remember we were standing on the side of the stage, and when he came up, I said, "Aaron, you have just sung about me." And so many things wow. were going on, and he said, "Well, y'all need to record it." And so we went in the studio probably within 2 months. Mm-hmm. And when we got into the studio, the producer, well, we had two producers at the time, mm-hmm. and they said, "Okay, we need to make this intro very short." So they tell the piano player, "So just make this short because it's got a lot of verses in it."
Yeah.
And when the piano player, Gary Priam, yeah. when he played that first piano roll, and I went, "The news came to Jesus," all of a sudden, I felt the goosebumps.
Wow.
And we knew we had something special with this song, and it is our signature song. Probably, I say, we'll be singing this song 100 years from now, but I guess probably if that was a song that would be dear to our hearts, it'd be 4 Days Late.
Well, now, don't you have the number one song on the charts right now? Sharon, talk about that.
Well, for the month of October, Pray Now is going to be the number one song in all of Southern gospel music. So we are so thrilled about that and just so thankful when the songs, when they touch the people's hearts, the listeners, because we record, every song we record, we've had an experience with that song because we listen to so many.
Right.
And so we have to narrow it down to 10 or 11 songs per album. So this is a very special and very timely song for us.
Now, you're going to be doing both of those songs tonight, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yes, we're doing songs, too, off a brand new album called Pray Now. Uh-huh. And Susan and I, we're very excited about the album. And so we'll be doing a lot of the new songs. But of course, we'll do some of our signature songs as well. But we want everybody to come out and be with us.
Okay, I want to ask you permission. We are going to be closing the show tonight. I would like to close it with one of your songs. Is that okay?
Oh, absolutely. Thank you so much.
Well, then that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to turn it back over to you guys, and we're going to listen to some music.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please came to Jesus. Please come fast. Lazarus is sick, and without your help, he will not last. Mary and Martha watched their brother die. They waited for Jesus. He did not come, and they wondered. The death watch was over, buried 4 days. Somebody said, he'll soon be here, the Lord's on his way. Martha ran to him, and then she cried. He'd still be alive. But you're 4 days late, and all hope is gone. Lord, we don't understand why you've waited so long. But his way is God's way, not yours. He's 4 days late, he's still on time. Jesus said, Martha, show me the grave. But she said, Lord, you don't understand. He's been there 4 days. The gravestone was rolled back. Jesus cried, Lazarus, come forth. Then somebody said, he's alive, he's alive. But he has not appeared. Friend, don't be discouraged, 'cause he's still the same. He'll soon be here. He'll roll back the stone, and he'll call out your name. When he's 4 days late, and all hope is gone. He's 4 days late. He's still on time.
He's still on time.
Oh, my God is great. When he's 4 days late, he's still on time. Just remember, he's still on time.
Hey, Jeff Jones here telling you we'll see you at the Dyer County Fair. Come on out and have some fun with us.
We've got a good thing growing at the Dyer County Fair starting Labor Day with Dixieland Carnival. Tuesday and Wednesday are pay one price night for $10. We'll draw for $1,000 nightly. Friday night is the new car giveaway and the truck and tractor pull with a special appearance of Bigfoot. The Mud Bog is Saturday night and we'll end the week with John Anderson in concert. Corn dogs, popcorn, funnel cakes. It's the Dyer County Fair. For more information about entry forms and fair sponsors, visit us at dyercountyfair.com.
Ooh,
We have a good thing growing at the 2015 Dyer County Fair. We'd like to welcome you to the 68th annual Dyer County Fair and our broadcasts of the sights and sounds of the 2015 Dyer County Fair with your hosts, Debbie Bradshaw Hart and Eric Maupin. Make plans to attend every night of the fair, including the crowning of the 2015 Miss Dyer County Fair. Don't miss any of the pageants, and also the King of Kings go-kart racing. A truck and tractor pull, livestock shows, fun for the kids, youth exhibits, the 4-H barnyard, commercial exhibits, Sorghum Valley, and this year's Midway features Dixieland Carnival Company. And don't forget, every night, we give away $1,000 from the First Citizens Amphitheater at 10:30. But remember, you must be present to win. Enjoy rides, games, pageants, exhibits, live Christian music, and with your admission on Saturday night, you get one of country music's premier artists, John Anderson, at the First Citizens Amphitheater, and so much more at this year's fair.